It's the kind of prediction you might find in a fortune cookie. Pinned to the top of Andrew Noymer's Twitter feed, dated January 31, 2020, it says, "Duct tape your underpants. 2020 is going to be a wild ride." It contradicted messaging from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, just days before, "Americans should not worry for their own safety." And from the soon-to-be beloved Dr. Anthony Fauci, just days after, "COVID-19's danger to the U.S., just minuscule." Noymer, an epidemiologist and demographer at UCI Irvine who studies infectious diseases, was already on the edge of his seat. 2019 novel coronavirus is more frightening than SARS plus certainly more than MERS B/C spreading more countries more quickly plus appears to have an appreciable case fatality rate, Noymer tweeted on January 30th, kicking off 240-character brawls with other scientists who insisted flu posed a greater risk. After a year of global pandemic and its attendant horrors, Noymer, and the rest of us, can look back at an agonizing, astounding year where science took center stage and delivered a bedazzling, if imperfect, performance. As the world awaits an encore, the promise of more scientific breakthroughs for other life-threatening diseases, Noymer can savor the three sweetest words in the English language: "You were right." This was a new coronavirus that we had never seen before, and the entire population was tabula rasa, a blank slate, he said. That's a big deal. Everyone on the planet was immunologically naive, which is a mouthful, but it means we had no resistance to it. Therefore, it was going to run through the whole population before it was over. And that's what's happening. The stars of the 2020 science show were, of course, vaccines, especially those based on mRNA technology, which essentially turns a person's cells into tiny drug manufacturing plants. Heretofore, the quickest vaccine ever developed was for the mumps, at a speedy 4 years. In 2020, advanced technology birthed multiple vaccines in about the time it takes a human baby to gestate. The three with emergency approval from the FDA are 100% effective in preventing severe disease and death, something nearly inconceivable a short year ago. I approach the mRNA vaccines, like most things we critique in science, with skepticism, said Philip L. Feldner, director of UC Irvine's Vaccine Research and Development Center and Protein Microarray Laboratory and Training Facility. The results provided by the vaccine developers seemed too good to be true, almost complete protection after one injection within 14 days. UCI Medical Center started vaccinating healthcare workers on December 16. Feldner's lab tracked the presence of antibodies in their blood over time. It was 13% at the start and up to 78% by late January.